being a disciple now, and my home church is Body of One Ministries, and we abbreviate that by saying BOOM, because if you go back and you try to put it all together, it actually spells out BOOM. And it's an amazing church, very small church, storefront, non-denominational church over in Orlando. And, well, I could also talk about our dear friends, Evoke Ministries, who are the amazing ministry that I was able to visit Columbia with twice. Also a very small, laid-back, you know, group of people, but just amazing and making an impact for Christ. Also, I work a lot with another ministry that I really, I didn't get a chance to really mention them, but it's one that's based out of my home church. They're actually called Native Society, and they're an awesome youth group. And so I just want to shout them out because they're starting up. I'm one of their youth leaders. I have the honor to serve alongside of the youth pastor there, and they are amazing, amazing. So specifically, if you have any kids that are between the ages of like 12 and 19, we'll take them because we love your kids, and we're over there at Body of One as well. I'm trying to think. Well,
Native Society. That's a great. That's a great title.
It's catchy, right?
We want to give a shout out to Native Society. If anybody's listening, we shout back or tweet us.
Hashtag Native Society. Yeah, yeah. Those are pretty much, you know, my teams that I work with there. I really appreciate everything. I work at Xulon Press, which is a part of film communication. That's also, I feel like all these places I'm naming, they're so tiny. I love, you know, my office, really awesome family there, tight-knit group. But we are a self-publisher, and we specialize in Christian self-publishing. So anybody that's out there that wants to publish their book, you know, you might want to give us a shout. And I work there in the marketing department where I work on services. I do press releases. I also work on video trailers for books.
What is the website for Xulon Press? If someone has a Christian book that they wanted to self-publish, what would they?
Yes, of course. The address is going to be xulonpress.com, which you're going to spell that a little bit wacky, but this is correct. It's X-U-L-O-N Press. PRESS.com,
Xulonpress.com.
We'll get you there.
Awesome.
Fantastic.
All right.
We love our friends at Xulon Press and Salem Communications.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
You guys too.
We just appreciate you so much, Amira, for coming on and sharing your heart with us. And as Mikey and I always say, there's someone or someones out there that needed to hear what you had to say. And
yep.
Not everybody says yes. That's the beauty of this deal. Mm-hmm.
Please get back in touch with us after your next mission trip, too, and
yes.
Give us a little update.
We'd love to have you come back. And
well, I'm also thinking of that that gentleman that she went to Columbia with, that the leader there, that sounds like he's got a pretty good testimony.
Oh, man, yeah. Scott is amazing. I actually was just thinking about that today. I was thinking about it. I'm like, I've got to get Scott to testify. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Evangelist Reinhardt Bunke.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Well, he's worked with him because Evangelist Bunke actually has his home base is in Orlando. It's called CFAN, Christ for All Nations. Scott actually used to work with him very closely. Scott ended up retiring. He felt like, well, from that position, but he felt like the Lord really called him to start a creative evangelistic ministry, which is what I'm a part of, and that basically what we do is we evangelize through the arts. And then besides that, of course, we do go at times, we talk to churches, we give testimonies, and we just share with them, you know, how the Lord has really called us to, you know, not necessarily just sit there in church, which is, it's great. You know, you've definitely got to sit under the word and really, you know, grow. But once you have, you know, felt like you're a disciple, you're not really just a new convert, that you should go out there and you should be preaching the gospel and making disciples like the word says. So that's really his heart. And it's amazing because I've seen a very small group of people touch so many others. And it's just been really awesome. So God is doing so much work. And I would definitely recommend him to you because you guys would just love it.
Well, awesome. Then we're going to put it on your lap. We're going to have you have Scott contact us.
Okay, sounds good.
Yes, please. We'll get Trish to mail you out some cards. So, you know, if you come across somebody in the grocery line, you go, here.
Absolutely.
Call these guys. They'll let you run your mouth. Oh, thank you again for coming on the show. You have been such a blessing.
Oh, man, thank you guys so much. You guys have been a blessing, and I've been praying for your families, Fritz specifically, and just, thinking about you guys a lot. So I really appreciate the opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being flexible. As my daughter had a pneumonia in her right lung, and we had to cancel on you.
Yeah.
Thank you for being so flexible. We appreciate it. And we're going to be praying about your missions trip and all the little details. And Father will bring it together and things will be great. And maybe you can give us an update when you get back.
Awesome. We'll do.
On behalf of the God Stories radio crew, we'd like to wish you and yours a Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
And a Happy New Year. It'll be next year before we talk to you again. So that wraps it up for Session 68. I'm Fritz.
I'm Mike.
And I'm Trish.
God bless.
God bless.
I have searched to find the meaning of this life, something that would fill my empty soul. Some believe a lie, choose darkness over light, but I will stand and let the whole world know. Mm-hmm.